Let me introduce myself again. So I'm Svetlana Valjina. I've been working for Smartly for the past 3 years, and I've been working with our gaming advertisers. A few words about Smartly. We are one of the leading Facebook marketing partners. That's why today we're going to talk about how to level up your user acquisition on Facebook. Cool. Today we're going to cover a few main topics. We will start with basic gaming mechanics on Facebook. Then we're going to talk how to gather resources and build your base. Also, we're going to touch upon how to learn about your key metrics and how to use it for optimization. And just to get an idea how familiar you are with Facebook marketing and how many of you already have been doing Facebook marketing and how big it is for you. Oh, wow. Cool. Good to know. Cool. Let's start then. So it's 2019 now, and I guess everybody done the 10 years challenge. Well, nothing changed much with me, hopefully. But of course, Facebook advertising changing dramatically and consumer behavior as well. So if you think about these numbers, 75% of the content would be in video format by 2020. And stories, they're replacing newsfeed. I mean, think how much time you spend on your Instagram feed daily. Sorry, Instagram stories daily. And also, you can think that you cannot trust anymore one data source. So people are looking at several third-party data. With that said, you can also think about competitiveness. It's highest at all time now. So, and also you can definitely see it in your CPIs or CPAs, depends on what you're looking at. But reaching the consumer with the right message at the right time, it's now more critical than ever. And how the winners manage to stay on top of everything with Facebook. So the winners are the ones who basically test and learn quicker from that, which ad is most relevant for their business and for their game. So if you think what keeps your game away from success, I would highlight 4 main bottlenecks. And the first one would be with several games in your portfolio, it's quite complicated to keep your creatives fresh and high quality constantly. Second would be repetitive manual work reduce your ability to focus on strategic aspect of your Facebook marketing. And the third point, it's close to impossible to broadly test content, measure effectiveness, and continuously maintains the performance at the same time. And of course, the fourth one would be there are so many changes happening on Facebook daily, so it's difficult to keep up with all the changes. But today we're going to talk how we can actually overcome all these changes. And I want to start with the main Facebook tools that you need to know before thinking about your Facebook advertising. So we're going to talk more in details during the presentation today, but I just want to highlight now. The first one would be ad formats. So there's so many different ad formats, starting from banners, video, carousel, creatives, canvas, and playables. So it's quite crucial to keep A/B testing to find the best combination that would work for you. Second would be tracking and analytics. It's quite crucial to look at your analytics and keep it clean and segment, and preferably by cohorts. Of course, also depends on your business model. And if we think about optimization, so you have to consider to do up event or value event optimization on Facebook. The last would be quite important tool. It's called lookalike audiences. It's one of the most efficient way to reach most relevant users for you without creating the exact profile. So that's are the main tools that you need to know before starting your Facebook marketing. And now we will move to level one, and we're going to talk how to gather your resources. Of course, every campaign starts with the gathering essential resources, and mobile gaming advertising is the same. And I can break down the resources into 3 main groups. It's audience, creative, and test data. And I'm going to walk you through each of it in details. If you talk about audience, Facebook offers few ways to target people. We have broad audience, mobile app custom audience, and lookalike audience. The broad audience, they are most traditional way to target on Facebook. So you basically can target by geography, by demographics, or by interest. So it's the oldest and most basic way to target people on Facebook. But obviously, it's not longer as efficient as it used to be. That's why we have mobile app custom audience. They allow you to target basically people based on their behavior in your app. You can target people, or you can track people who watch ads in the app. You can track people who did some purchase in the app or accomplished certain action in your app. And then there are actually two ways that you can use how you can use custom audiences. The first one would be to use it for retargeting. If you have already quite mature game, then you can start retargeting user on Facebook. And the second one would be to use it as a seed audience for lookalikes. And that's how we move to lookalikes audience. And lookalikes, as I mentioned before, they are proven to be most efficient way of targeting on Facebook. They allow you to go broad, but at the same time to keep the user profile quite quite exact, let's say. Those are the main audience that you should think about when you're thinking about targeting on Facebook. Now we're going to talk about creatives. Nowadays, you need more ads than ever. If you think about, like, we did a research with our most successful advertisers, and we discovered that advertisers actually now use 11 times more creative assets than they used to use 2 years ago. I mean, think about how many different placements you have on Facebook, and of course, ideally, you have to have creatives for each of it. And also, when you think about creative, you have to think about personalization, or how you can customize your creatives for high value audience for you. Keep your content fresh. We recommend to refresh creatives, like, ideally every second week, in ideal world again. And of course, it's important to always keep testing. With that in mind, I want to introduce you the creative testing framework that in Smartly we develop for our users. Basically, this framework allows you, with all your current video assets, or like creative assets, it's not necessary to be video, use all your assets to create all possible combination to test. And then it gives you testing the structure approach. For example, you can use it you can have the same video concept or banner concept and test it with different languages. Or you can, again, have the same format and test it with different formats in which placement it would perform best for you. So that's how it looks. We call it modular video production. Again, it can apply also to banner production. You just put different video assets in the data source that we take into our platform. And then we run special script that would match all these creative assets and create all possible variations. And then as a result, you get 100 plus creative to test. As you can see here, you will get like different background, different like call to action, different gameplays. It really depends on your concept of your creative. But that's super cool thing to keep your creatives fresh and test what works best for you. And yeah, we're already testing it a lot with our customers. And as you can see, we get quite good results. Our customer Kazumo, they basically reduce the costs on video production by 50% by using our modular approach and video template. Cool. Also, if you are looking for more interactive way to show your game, you can try playable ads. And playable ads, they essentially allow users to try your game before downloading it. So that's recently new, or like the latest ad format on Facebook. And again, like our customers been using it and testing it quite heavily, and already get quite good results, like 34% lower cost per purchase. It's quite good, I would say. So after you gather your knowledge about the audiences and you found what format of creatives works best for you, it's time to move to level 2 and time to think about how to build your base. When you think about Facebook marketing, you can split it into three main stages. First would be campaign. On the campaign level, you define how you want to optimize your campaign. You define the objective. It can be app install, it can be app event optimization, it can be value optimization. It's really up to your business. On the ad set level, we have the targeting options. So you can define your target audience and placement and budgets. On the ads level, we have the ads format and different like content options. So let's see. We discover that actually you have to think about structure strategically, and it really depends on the phase of your game. If your game is on the test phase, we recommend, in terms of creative, we recommend to test as many options as you can to find like what resonates best with your audience. In terms of the audience, if you don't have previous games in your portfolio and you're starting from scratch, it's always good to start with broad audience, the option that I described before. So in the first ad set, you can start with the interest or keywords. In the second ad set, it can be competitors' games that are most similar to your game. And then as soon as you get first conversion, you have to think about trying lookalikes audience. In terms of Facebook objective, you can start with app install to get as many conversions as you can and test app event optimization on just few markets to see how it would work for you. And as a success metric, it would be helpful to get data for your LTV model and launch strategy. And that's how we move to the launch phase. So you already on the launch phase, you already have some data from test phase. And then you can use it already for that. So for example, you can select top performing creatives and assign it according to the audience. Then in terms of the audience, we recommend to switch to lookalikes already because by that time you would already have enough conversion to create lookalikes. And you can create two types of lookalike. You can use lookalikes based on the data from the test phase and lookalikes from multi-country. So you can go wild and do like worldwide lookalikes, up to you. And then in terms of campaign objective, you can still use app install if you don't get enough conversion data, but we recommend to move more towards app event optimization for core markets, at least. And then of course, in terms of success metrics, you just have to think how to execute and improve your Facebook strategy based on new data that you will constantly be getting. And then when you reach the maturity phase, it's time to think about refreshing creatives. And again, like try to customize and personalize creatives as much as you can, that they, again, will resonate with your high-value markets. In terms of audience, you already have like all the data for lookalikes, and you can start testing value-based lookalikes. The difference is that apart from the seed audience, you can also insert the value that you want or willing to get from these people. Or you can, for example, you will get already like split of users who's like spent much time in your app, or users who it's not necessary to be money value of users. So again, like you can use split users who spend much time in your app, or users who pay for something in your app. So that's what value-based lookalike is. And then you can still keep the lookalikes that you use on the launch phase. Just refresh it. In terms of campaign objective, focus fully on app event optimization or value optimization. Well, try to move from app installs fully. And success metrics would be improving your LTV calculation based on the cohort data already. When your game reached the final stage, it's time to think about the re-engagement strategy because you already got a big user base. And there's high probability that some of the users, they are not engaged as they used to be with your game. So that's why it's time to think about how to get back these users. So that's why we recommend to use more like gameplay videos as a creative format. So basically you can showcase like different new features in your game or like different things that you offer in the game. And in terms of the audience, you can start retargeting, create retargeting audiences from your SDK or mobile measurement partner data. So it can be all installed users or all users that have been inactive in your app. And again, in terms of campaign optimization, you can use create re-engagement campaign with app event or value optimization. And as a success metric, you should look at your revenue from campaigns and make sure that you get healthy ROAS at that stage. So that's how we look at the structure in strategic way. And here I just want to highlight some our best practices as well. Well, keep your campaign structure as simple as possible. Try to avoid granular split. So when you create different campaign, create it only for different Facebook objectives. Or you can also create for the audience with different conversion value. For example, you can split geography by tiers, and tier one would be US, Canada, UK, and tier two, Germany and France. So in that case, it also makes sense to split the campaigns because obviously you would get different costs and different metrics for these countries. When you think about splitting the ad sets, split it only when you have significant difference in value, in conversion value for each audience group. So again, it can be like splitted by cohorts. If you do cohort analysis already, for example, you can target users with positive cohort on day seven or like day three. So that's the ad set split. And then always keep running different ad formats because, again, it's changing so rapidly that what worked yesterday might not work tomorrow. Cool. So after you know, you gather your resources, you build your base, it's time to focus on your key metrics. And there are three main KPIs that gaming advertisers are looking at. Here we've got return on ad spend, return on investment, and lifetime value. Return on ad spend is the most important metric, I would say, in digital world. And it basically measures how much revenue you get from every dollar spent on your ad. And then when you think about ROAS, you have to think that you are not buying a single user, but a group of users. That's why cohort analysis is coming at handy here. And basically, like, you can use cohort analysis to understand user behavior better. And for example, you can split again users by behavior. For example, cohort, it's actually the time that user would spend to accomplish second action in your app. For example, we can track users who install the app and made a purchase or watch ads on the day one. So that would be most valuable users for you because there is high probability that they actually would accomplish second action or third action faster. So, and for example, you can also use cohort analysis for optimization. So it's likely that that group of users that didn't bring you any revenue on the day seven would bring you any return on investment or return on ad spend. So, and it might be a good strategy to just turn off the ad set or the ad with these metrics. Actually, if we speak about cohort analysis, it also applies to return on investment and actually to LTV as well. So it's just a way to analyze your data in general. So, and moving to return on investment, it's basically, I would say, it's most precise metric for advertisers. If you think what is the difference between return on ad spend and return on investment, you can see it from the formula already. So return on ad spend, take into account only the spend from your Facebook activities, only spend that you the money that you spent on the campaign. The return on investments, it's actually more complex metric. So, and it's also like more like a model than metric. So it can include different factors. For example, you can include all the costs that were involved in the Facebook marketing here. It can be cost on video production, cost on overtime of your UA managers, or like fee for Facebook marketing partners, anything here. So, and it gives you like better understanding of your business if you look at ROI. So that's the main difference. And moving to LTV, LTV is actually the basic definition of LTV is the total revenue that user brings you during the lifetime. And the lifetime is defined as time from the first engagement with your app to the last moment or to the last engagement in your app. So that's the LTV definition. Unfortunately, there is no universal way to calculate LTV. It's really tied to your business. So, and you have to think about all factors that would affect it. But it's a good way to look at it, you know? It's a good way to look at your Facebook marketing through the LTV model. So that's about main metrics that you have to know. And then, of course, like none of the metric matters if you don't have it in the reporting, and you can use it, you cannot use it for optimization. So that's why in Smartly we build the advanced reporting, which we call pivot tables. And here you can get as granular split of your data as you want. So you can do like cohort analysis here to understand the revenue cohorts of each game if you have different games in your portfolio to do benchmark. Or you can even do it by country, by creatives. You can even do the best, you can even do split by creatives element to see like what are the winning combinations for you. So yeah, keep in mind, like after you got your metrics, you need to keep it clear and to look at it, maybe not every day, but quite often. And that's how we move to the level 4. And we're gonna talk about optimization here, how to use your metrics for optimization. So Facebook offers you few ways to optimize your campaigns, but I would say most common ways is up event optimization, when you want to find users who are most likely to accomplish a certain action in your app, in your game. Or the second way is value optimization. And value optimization, it's more like when you're looking for users who are most likely to bring you certain return on ad spend. So basically, here you just insert your target ROAS data, and Facebook would try to find you users who are most likely to bring you these return investments. So that's a key Facebook ways to optimize. But of course, if you want to bring your performance to the next level, we always recommend to look at AI features that are offered on the market. And like if I talk about our AI features, they totally align with all Facebook mechanisms. And with our AI features, you can leverage Facebook campaign budget optimization just by adding smartly predictive predictive budget optimization with across multiple campaigns and with other like third-party data if you don't trust Facebook data as much as you do other sources. And of course, you can also set up rules that would be also switching your budget or changing the creative status based on the performance. And again, you can use for optimization not only first-party data like Facebook, but also the third-party data. And our customers, like I would say also the AI optimization is quite common among our customers. So as you can see, our cool win is Chinese customers. They gain 34% ROI increase by using third-party data integration and smartly AI-based budget allocation. So cool. Wow, that's been that was fast. So after you master all the levels that I just went through, so I can say that you've reached the GOAT status of Facebook advertising. So, and there are a few key takeaways that I want you to go home with. First one would be Facebook advertising is accelerating and you need more ads than ever. Second is when you think about structure your campaigns, you have to have a hard look at your campaigns and try to avoid all the granular split and keep it simple, broad and simple, to leave Facebook a lot of room for optimization. Third one, so you should really know your metrics and make most out of your data. So you should basically build all your decision based on this data. And the fourth would be that you have to set up you have to use your advanced metric for optimization and set up your way to optimize it and follow them. And that would actually help you set up your title for success. Well, actually, one more thing. The FMPs, Facebook Marketing Partners, here are not just to take your money, but also to allow you to take a strategic approach to your Facebook marketing. Cool. That concludes my presentation, and I'm happy to answer any questions you have, guys.
So how accurate do you think, so how much of the planning should we do based on the taste phase into the launch phase? Because of course when you're in soft launch, you're not in your tier one countries, you're somewhere in your soft launch countries in a very cheap Philippine or whatever based third world country you have, and the users behave a little bit different. So how much of the testing results do you actually translate one-to-one into your launch strategy?
Well, actually, that's like we've been discussing last week. Last week I was at Facebook office and we were discussing that actually that's not right approach to test and like to do soft launch on the cheap countries. Yeah, I understand from cost perspective, but exactly what you said, that the users are totally different. So, and the data becomes quite irrelevant for the launch phase, if you think about that. So that's why we recommend to at least to spend part of the budget on your tier one countries, if you think about testing. So, and how long, it really depends, like, depends on your game a lot. So if your game just flies, then it might be 2-3 weeks is enough already, but if its game is a bit more complicated, it takes more time to understand the mechanic of the game, so it might take longer on the market, because people would need to spend some time to learn the game. So there is no, again, like, one recipe for all advertisers, unfortunately.
Yeah, I usually try to at least cover the LTV before the launch.
But that's a really good approach, to look at your LTV first, so to think about your LTV model and LTV estimation when you're testing the game, so to get the idea about behavior, user behavior.
Yeah, the biggest problem is trying to fight to actually soft launch the game in even tier two countries. Mm-hmm. That's a big fight between marketing and production, because nobody wants to have their game outed in a country where they expect to have a lot of money later on after launch. And they don't want to put a beta version of the game in there. So I'm not sure how you approach this on your side.
Well, on our side, of course we go aligned with the customer, so we don't like really push the customer if they don't want to test. But of course, like, we just warn the customers that the data that you get from these markets are quite not relevant for the key targets that you want to target later. So yeah, you can test the game itself, but in terms of Facebook advertising, this data a bit, like, you have to be quite skeptical when you look at it. So, more questions, guys? Yeah.
Hey, thanks for the presentation. And this sounds more like marketing for mobile apps, right?
Well, yeah, I've been asked this question right before my speech.
Yeah.
Yes, I have to say, like, we have 80% of our advertisers focusing on mobile. But historically, we started with desktop advertisers. That's why I cannot split, like, mobile and desktop advertisers, if you mean desktop, or you're talking about console as well.
I want to ask any particular differences between marketing for mobile and for PC.
The main difference would be the tracking instrument. Because, like, if you think about, like, mobile tracking, so you have a lot of mobile measurement partners like Adjust, AppsFlyer, Tune, and other names. So, and they're quite granular in their targeting. They can target anything in your apps, like literally anything. And and then we can use this data for optimization. When we're talking about PC, you have different tracking instruments. So I would say that is the biggest difference. But also, like the difference can be in the game itself. So probably the PC game, the like funnel in the game is a bit different. So you have different stages. But again, if you set up good tracking, so it's still like would everything what I just said would apply to PC marketing as well.
Okay, thanks.
I saw some questions.
Yeah, would it also apply to consoles?
With consoles is a bit trickier. To be honest, I never work with consoles, but I would love to see how is the Facebook marketing activities set up, so to tell you more. So we can chat after the session in more details if you want.
All right, sure.
My question is really simple. How long do you run ads, or how much data do you need to collect on an ad before you make a decision about whether to cut it or to switch creatives?
How long? It's a good question, actually. And again, it really depends on the game. So I would say that the main trend in the like my recent gaming advertisers, I've seen that they run campaign in general for 1-2 weeks, and then it just dies out slowly. And then it's like sometimes it just helps to relaunch the same campaign, you know? It's like nobody can explain why, but that's how it works. In terms of the ad, like, I would say at least a couple of days of testing, like 2-3 days of testing, one ad. But you have to make sure that the ad gets at least 1,000 impressions per day. So then you can make some decision based on this result. If it gets like less impressions, then it's like most probably the testing was set up not right. So, but yeah, overall it's like 1-2 days for ad, two weeks to 1 month for campaigns. More questions, guys? Yeah, I see one question over there. Can we?
So I have a question about lookalike audiences. We have a game that was shut down 5 years ago by Kabam. We relaunched it recently.
Yeah.
And the game was on Facebook. Mm-hmm. So the good news is that like 50,000 people from that particular platform are still, you know, connected to Facebook, and they're tracked by Facebook. And, mm-hmm. you know, Facebook does not delete the data practically mm-hmm. ever. So is there any way to say we want those types of users from that particular app and create a lookalike audience based on that cohort of those users? Like, I was trying to do that and I just didn't see it.
Well, basically, what you have to keep in mind is like, it's 5 years ago. Probably the users that you want to target or use as a seed audience, they actually grown up already, so. And
oh no, we cater to like old people, so that's all
okay.
Right. Like,
so
they're either
the
dead
fine
right now, or they are still going to play the game. So it's all right.
I
know it's dark
game
humor, but you know that's how it is, and not everybody makes games for 12-year-olds. Some people make them for adults.
Okay.
And grandpas, they need to play games too.
Cool. Well, then you can definitely try to use your like target the seed audience for lookalikes. It wouldn't hurt if you're sure that
they... Yeah, like what I was doing, I was targeting, like I have an ad that's continuously just showing to those 50,000 people when they just log in mm-hmm. on Facebook, but I was wondering if I can just take that audience and say, I want to target every single person in the world that's like this dude here.
Yes, that's what lookalikes normally do. So how lookalikes works is like you take the seed audience, like these 50,000 people, you put it to the like audience creation, and then you choose the country, whether I want to, like US, to find all US users that are similar to this group of people, or like any other countries comes to your mind, and then you select the percentage of similarity. That's how lookalike works. So that would be perfectly cool case for lookalikes.
Thank you. I just couldn't set it up, so that's why I asked.
But yeah, you should definitely go for it.
All right, thanks.
Welcome.
Right, any more questions?
Yeah, we're already done with Q&A. I finished